Hello everyone. Today we'll discuss meaning and definition and the clinical symptoms of mentally challenged children or individual. In introduction, challenged condition makes the normal function of individual very difficult and lead to dependency. These conditions are increasing day by day due to the changing lifestyle and complicated environment. Challenged children is one who deviate from normal health status either physically, mentally or socially and require special care, treatment and education. Let us see the concept of challenged state. Initially, an individual will come with injury or disease that will lead to impairment, and that impairment make an individual disabled, and disabled state make a person in a state of challenged or handicapped condition. Let us see what is impairment. It defines as any loss or abnormality of psychological, physiological or anatomical structure or function is known as impairment. For example, loss of vision, loss of hearing, etc. Primary impairment may lead to secondary impairment. For example, defective hearing results in learning difficulty or poor school performance. Therefore, impairment leads to disability. Disability is something it develops as the consequences of impairment. For example, loss of limbs result inability to walk. Disability is the inability to carry out certain activity which are considered as normal for the age and the sex. Handicap or challenged state can be defined as a disadvantage for a given individual resulting from an impairment or a disability that limits and prevents the fulfillment of a role which is normal for the individual depending on age, sex, social or cultural factor. Primary handicap may lead to secondary handicap condition. We can give an example like blindness lead to economical handicap situation. If we see the classification of challenged state, we can classify into three levels: physically challenged, mentally challenged and socially challenged. Physically challenged is a condition where children can be grouped according to the affected part of the body. These include some of the physiological diseases or abnormalities. If we look into the mentally challenged state, it is nothing but significantly sub-average general intellectual functioning resulting in or associated with concurrent impairment in adaptive behavior and manifest during the developmental period. If we see the third category of challenged state is socially challenged. Here, they are having disturbed opportunities for healthy personality development due to social factor leading to non-achievement of full potentiality. Social disturbances are found in the form of broken family, parental inadequacy, loss of parents, poverty, lack of educational opportunity, environmental deprivation and so on. Today we are discussing more in terms of mentally challenged state, or rather even it is called as intellectually challenged. Intellectually disabled or challenged is also called as intellectual development disorder. Formerly, it was known as mental retardation. Mental retardation is a developmental disability that first appears in children under the age of 18. It is characterized as a level of intellectual functioning that is well below average and results in significant limitations in the person's daily living skills. We can say in short, adaptive functioning. If we go to a definition of mental retardation, it is a significant sub-average general intellectual functioning that is below 70 of IQ, resulting in or associated with concurrent impairment in adaptive behavior and manifested during the developmental period. Diagnostic criteria of mental retardation. Criteria A says that significantly sub-average intellectual functioning, that is, as I mentioned, IQ of approximately 70 or below of that. Criteria B says that concurrent deficit or impairments in present adaptive functioning, that is, the person's effectiveness in meeting the standards as expected for his or her age by his or her cultural group in at least two of the following. They are communication, self-care, home living, social or interpersonal skill, use of community resources, self-direction, functional academic skills, work, leisure, health and safety. The diagnostic criteria C says that the onset should be before the age of 18 years. Intellectual functioning or IQ is usually measured by a test called IQ test. The average score is always 100. People scoring below of 70 or 75 are thought to have a mental retardation, or rather we can say intellectually disabled individual. What a child can do in comparison to other children of his or her age or certain skill are important to adaptive behavior. Let us see the classification. The first classification comes as profound mental retardation. The IQ range is below 20. The second classification is severe mental retardation. IQ range is 20 to 34. The third one is moderate mental retardation. The IQ range is 35 to 49. The mild mental retardation is 50 to 69. And the last classification is borderline intellectual functioning, that is 70 to 84. If we see the educational classification of mental retardation is educable category. They could learn simple academic skills but not progress above the eighth. Could learn simple academic skills but not progress above sixth grade. Trainable is a second category where they could learn to care of their daily needs but very few academic skills. The last category is unattainable or custodial type, totally dependent, where considerable in need of long-term care, possibly in a residential setting. Children with intellectual disability vary widely in their degree of disability. Some show cognitive impairment from early infancy, such as limited vocalization or poor self-regulation, whereas other impairment may go relatively unnoticed throughout the elementary school years. Let us discuss in detail about the classification of mental retardation. As I mentioned, the first one is mild mental retardation. It constitutes for the large number of those diagnosed with mental retardation. In an educational context, people in this group are considered as educable. Their intellectual level as adults are comparable with those of average 8 to 10 year old children. They do not show signs of brain path. They do not show signs of brain pathology or other physical abnormality, but often they require some measures of supervision because of their limited ability to foresee the consequences of their action. They need special services to maximize their potential. With early diagnosis, parental assistance and special educators programs will help this individual to adjust socially, master simple academic and occupational skills and become self-supported citizens. The second group is moderate mental retardation. These individuals are likely to fall in the educational category of trainable. It measures that they are presumed able to measure certain routine skills like cooking, gardening, or some other specialized instruction for their activity. Their intellectual ability reaches to the level of 4th to 7-year-old children. Some can be taught to read and write a little and manage to achieve fair commands of spoken language. Their rate of learning is very slow and limited. Physically, they usually appear clumsy and they suffer from bodily deformities and poor motor coordination. Some of these people are hostile and aggressive too. Very rarely, some people have extraordinary musical skills with an inadequate explanation. Early diagnosis, parental help and adequate opportunity for training, most moderate retarded individual can achieve. Partial independence in daily self-care, acceptable behavior, economic usefulness in the family or other sheltered environment. The third category is severe mental retardation. They also called as dependent retarded. In this individual, motor and speech development are severely retarded and sensory defects and motor handicap are common. They can develop limited level of personal hygiene and self-help skills but dependent on others for care. However, some extent of training can make them to perform simple occupational tasks under supervision. The last group of mental retardation is profound mental retardation. They also referred as life support retarded. They are severely deficient in adaptive behavior and unable to master by build the simple task. Speech is also in abnormal level, and severe physical deformation and central nervous system problems we can see, and they need a custodial care all their life and a short life expectancy. By looking into these classification, we can understand that intervention effects are the most successful when offered at the earliest point in time, especially through the preschool years. Intervention for children with intellectual disability are matched to the child's individual needs and ability and are integrated with family, school and community. Successful intervention often include behaviorally based training and educational component that teach specific skill and reduce undesirable behavior. In conclusion, children need access to a range of legitimate opportunity and to long-term support from parents, teachers, and caregivers who care deeply about them. Thank you all.